Good evening all, I'm Lithi Lama with the Tuesday night edition of South Asian News. Welcome to Vision of Asia, voice of our community. We are coming to you from our studio in New York City. Here's what's happening tonight in the coronavirus pandemic. Globally, we are looking at more than 1 million deaths from the novel virus with a sobering number of 35.5 million cases. The United States has surpassed 7.5 million cases of COVID-19 with at least 210,000 deaths. As the nation continues to grapple with COVID-19, only four states are currently showing a downward trend in new COVID cases: Hawaii, Kansas, Missouri, and South Carolina. Meanwhile, 22 states are showing upward trends and 24 states are showing steady trends. States such as Indiana, Kentucky, Wisconsin, and Wyoming have set new records for new cases and deaths, with Wisconsin currently being the sharply hit with the pandemic. Here in New York, once the epicenter, the state is experiencing a jump in cases as well. In the city here, 9 zip codes in Brooklyn and Queensboro have been identified with surging cases. Today, public and private schools were ordered to close in those zip codes, along with non-essential businesses and indoor dining also shuttered. Governor Andrew Cuomo said that New York will definitely crack down on these COVID-19 hotspot clusters with new rules and bans on mass gatherings. This is all happening while the first indication of whether coronavirus vaccine candidates are safe and effective won't be ready until November or December of this year. On vaccine, the World Health Organization also has said that the vaccine against the novel virus may be ready by year's end, and the WHO has called for solidarity and political commitment from all leaders to ensure an equal distribution of vaccines when they become available. The World Health Organization also aims to distribute 2 billion doses by the end of 2021. And President Donald Trump continues to recover at the White House from COVID-19. Our best wishes here for the President and First Lady's speedy recovery. On economy, the President has ordered negotiators to halt talks with House Democrats over the new and much-anticipated COVID-19 relief package after both parties struggled for months to reach a deal. What do you think should happen with the stimulus package, and what has been your experience with this economic ramification of COVID-19? Write to us on events@itvgold.com. We look forward to showcasing more stories from our community. With that, let's begin tonight's South Asian News segment with much on the impact of the pandemic. Here are the headlines. New Era Virtual International Couture Fashion Week 2020 Fashion Community Week. American Association of Physicians of Indian Origin hosts 2020 Chicago Mini Convention, Illinois. Renowned Sadhguru kicks off mystical road trip across the United States, Isha Foundation. A lot more on the other side of the break. Stay with us in Vision of Asia, voice of the community. We'll be back shortly. Welcome back. I'm Aditi Lama, and this is Vision of Asia, Tuesday night episode of South Asian News. On COVID-19 relief efforts and the tireless work of nationwide medical professionals and doctors, the American Association of Physicians of Indian Origin, AAPI, held its 2020 Chicago mini convention in Illinois. We have been showcasing multiple segments from the very successful outside convention, which adhere to the rules of social distancing and masking up, and gather South Asian doctors, supporters, and elected officials to honor the contributions and advancement of the member body of the association. The convention was a forum for AAPI members to network, share knowledge, and discuss innovation, while also provide much in discussion on the role of healthcare workers in the pandemic. Chief guest of convention, Vice President of India, Sri Naidu, urged AAPI fraternity to share their Indian counterparts and Indian Medical Association the valuable and invaluable experiences gained by Indian doctors working abroad to tackle various health issues in the subcontinent. With that, we have tonight the best highlights from the convention featuring various sessions, award ceremony, speech addresses and culture performances. Here is a story which also saw a message from ITV Gold's chairman, Padma Shri Dr. Sudhir Parekh. Do visit AAPIUSA.org for more information.
As you can see, today we are celebrating our annual mini convention. It was supposed to be celebrated in June, but because of the COVID pandemic lockdowns, we had to postpone it to September. On behalf of all AAPI, myself, Dr. Reddy, President, and the ECBOT, I would like to thank everyone.
And again, I thank you all the members for their support and during my presidency, and best wishes to ITV. Thank you.
It's what?
So, thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Dr. Meher Medavaram. I'm the convention chair for the AAPI convention for year 2020. It is really wonderful to have everybody come in for the convention. This was originally planned for June 2020, but because of the COVID situation, we had to cancel it, and we were doing this only because we would like to recognize all the doctors who hard worked throughout the year, and also really a tribute to several of the physicians who have really fallen ill but are recovering, and some we lost. So this is a great tribute, and we would like to recognize each and every one. That is the reason for our convention. In spite of all the odds, we are following the guidelines of CDC, which is only 100 people. So the event is attended by about 100 physicians. And
Thank you very much. Thank you, Dr. Sudhir Parekh, Parekh Media, and great leader of AAPI and GAPIO, who has been a phenomenal support for all of us and a role model for all of us young leaders. We are following in your footsteps and bringing our AAPI into the forefront through your media presence, as well as various encouraging projects you are taking all over the country, across the globe as well. Thank you, Dr. Sudhir Parekh, again. So I'm Dr. Ravi Kohli. I'm the Vice President of AAPI. And we just concluded our mini convention in Chicago and governing body meeting. We had a fruitful and very meaningful discussions here today. And we have come to many good understandings of projects and programs and improvement that we can implement. And all the congeniality and camaraderie felt very much. Having been stuck at home with webinars and various remote meetings, we were kind of fatigued with that. So we're so glad to be here in a safe and very effective way. We're meeting Dr. Suresh Reddy and Dr. Meher Madhavaram, who are the past president and mini convention chair, have done a wonderful arrangement. So please support us and please join us wherever and whenever we have our next event. And again, Dr. Ravi Kohli, vice president of AAPI. Thank you very much for your support.
We have now highlights from the recently held New Era Virtual International Couture Fashion Show 2020 presented by Fashion Community Week. The virtual event comprised of a runway show along with a panel discussion featuring fashion industry pioneers. The runway show saw evening and bridal couture with a fashion statement created with an essence of modernistic West meets the exotic East. The global event surely brought together the glamour and ambience of fashion virtually during this pandemic, with models showcasing gorgeous gowns with intricate detailing, presented couture collections of the season, featuring designers Ibayo, Kyra Afrique, Newbie Collections, Carlitas, Rana Saman, and Elite Pour La Vie. The panel discussion highlighted innovative fashion tech companies that are some of the change makers in the evolving fashion industry. Many spoke on the impact of these fashion tech companies in making fashion more accessible and integrated into the digital media space. Here are some glimpses from the virtual event.
Hello, I am Shireen Hashim, CEO and founder of the award-winning Fashion Community Week established since 2014. We are a business and marketing platform that offers support and opportunities for emerging global fashion designers and brands. Since our existence, we have launched and presented brands from 40 countries covering six continents. Through our platform, presenting brands takes part in our exhibition, showroom, shopping event, conference, and of course our famous runway shows, which is held biannually. This season, we're launching an online incubator for emerging fashion designers and brands and offering the following. We offer interview series with industry experts, an e-boutique platform for our fashion designers to sell their collections, one-on-one consulting services and workshops on brand launch and development, and now introducing our first ever virtual Fashion Week this season. Welcome to the opening day of our New Era interactive virtual Fashion Week powered by Fashion Community Week. Today is our worldwide fashion tech conference taking place in a form of panel discussion with five fashion industry founders joining us to share about their innovative fashion tech companies and how they are impacting the future of the fashion industry.
I started this size around 6 years ago, and I started with one goal of solving the sizing and the fitting problem in fashion e-commerce. At Easy Size, we use AI and machine learning to address this problem, and we do it in a way that doesn't require any body measurements, size charts, or garment measurements. When it comes to sizing, we try to understand consumers' unique style and fit preferences. And based on that, we design the user experience to be as smooth, as seamless, and as frictionless as possible.
For sure. Thank you for having me here as well. Such an honor, especially for a fashion week that's on the other side of the world. Love it. So at IntelliStyle, we personalize the customer experience of fashion retailers by styling their customers with the right clothes and outfits for them. Well, at the same time, we optimize conversion, basket size, and repeat purchase rate. So the core product is the AI that learns by looking at outfits put together by some of the world's most prestigious stylists and then extracts the essence of style. It uses that knowledge to style customers based on the latest trends, as well as who that customer actually is. So there's a number of use cases that retailers use it for. The most recent one is remote selling to turn their customer service team into expert stylists, as well as personal shopping, styling recommendations on the web, on chatbots, CRM, email, as well as physical smart mirrors that we're integrated in.
So Savvy Wardrobe is a digital wardrobe management platform. We use artificial intelligence and machine learning to create digital version of people's wardrobe and also to streamline sustainable living. We do that by curating an ecosystem of services such as donation, repairs, cleaning, reselling, and everything related to the wardrobe management is curated in the app. We've started with the project a while ago, but we are live since March 2020, and the whole ethos of Save Your Wardrobe is based on the way I grew up in Tunisia and this, my family's sustainable and circular values. And I'm really excited to be at this panel. Thank you.
We are Else Corp. It is a deep tech company offering B2B, B2B2C solutions to brand, retailers, manufacturers, and somehow to independent designers. We basically elaborated a kind of cloud technology that is able to put together a front end dedicated to product personalization in 3D. So we're quite experts in 3D. We call it, to simplify, 3D commerce, but internally it is all about design automation. Then probably I will give more insights on it. And then it goes to generate made to order orders. So from our side, we are connected to manufacturing processes. We try to be a middleware that intends to help fashion industry becoming more sustainable in a way of approaching in an easier and simple way the on-demand prospect. No? So on-demand, made to order, all these complicated points, we work on it and have different experience and success. And then later I will tell now how it works.
I love that, you know, there's so much innovation happening in this sector. 3D look actually comes at the whole fit and sizing from the first part of the supply chain, which is all about bodies. So essentially what we do is we turn bodies into fit charts, and we're an AI first B2B company. We use a combination of computer vision and deep learning and 3D body matching, and we create a 3D avatar. So it's a lot of statistical modeling, but we're coming at it from the understanding that if you really think about it, fashion makes clothing for bodies, but we don't know what the bodies look like. So our technology actually generates a 3D avatar. And from that, if you think about it, we could hypothetically compute hundreds of different measurements. We compute today about 73 in our API. But what we're really looking to do is personalize the experience, knowing that we're moving towards a world of customization and personalization, not standardization in an industry that has never been standardized. So we're really looking at what is an individual customer's body shape and body measurements, and how does that fit with the current product? Of course, much deeper than that is being able to use this body data to affect the supply chain. So how do we think about design? How do we think about manufacturing? How do we think about inventory and distribution? So that ultimately we're lowering return rates and we're actually making an indentation on the amount of waste that this industry contributes to the world.
It's time for the short break on Vision of Asia, Voice of the Community. Come right back to us. And welcome again. This is Vision of Asia, the South Asian news segment, and I am Aditi Lamba. We have now a segment featuring renowned spiritual leader, author, philanthropist, and founder of the Isha Foundation, Sadhguru. A name known to millions by his supporters across the globe, Sadhguru has kicked off a mystical road trip to the United States during this pandemic to truly understand the deepest roots of legacy and land in this nation. In a 10,000-mile journey, Sadhguru is exploring internal and external landscapes of the U.S., by riding his bike from Tennessee through 15 states to engage and learn about the history, culture, and modern lives of Native Americans. The journey is titled Motorcycles and a Mystic, a thorough discussion of the indigenous legacy of Americans and 500 years since the arrival of European explorers in the 15th century. Highlighting the cultural beliefs and practices of Native Americans, Sadhguru himself interviewed people in this journey, embracing the intimate connection with land, elements, and natural forces. Here is a segment of Sadhguru's motorcycle and mystic journey.
They have been living in this land for anywhere between 10 to 40,000 years.
And I could see his spirit, it's very strong.
For over 5,000 years, a city with a whole elaborate spiritual and religious processes and rituals existed. Be with us, ride with me. We are here right now at Bear Butte, Black Hills. This region is sacred for the Lakota Nation. Crazy Horse, one of the most well-known and quite a remarkable leader of the Lakotas. His father received his vision here at the Bear Butte.
This gift that I'm going to present to my friend is not coming from me. It's coming from this mountain, from the Creator. These are the most sacred to us, the most sacred. And the prayer that is with us, to be with you on your journey. Whenever you leave home, they're going to take care of you, be with you. Whatever you ask for, that will come to be. Oye, Makiayo. It was really beautiful. It was like him and I was walking on the clouds and we flew into each other. Very powerful, and I could see his spirit, it's very strong, and I hope he prays for us too. It was awesome, beautiful. That's why I said I hope to see him again someday. Thank you for coming here. The things we shared, we talked about. Now he knows me better. And maybe our visions will come together someday.
In this Lakota country right now, it is very, very eye-opening to see how they were fond of Mother Earth, how they structured their life around that, and how they lived in tune with nature, with absolute passion for everything around them and a certain sense of dispassion about their own life, about their own death. I think there is a lot that modern societies need to pick up from ancient societies, because there was a certain cohesiveness with life around them. Without that cohesiveness, everything seems to be a problem.
Well, this is all for tonight's show. Remember to send us your suggestions and get your voices and organizations on our show. Email us on events@itvgold.com or follow us on Facebook at @itvgold. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel to watch many of our popular shows for free. Thank you for joining us tonight from Queens, New York. This is Vision of Asia, and I am Aditi Lamba. Take care and be well.